Hello everyone, welcome back to my classes on retail promotion. Our today's topic is develop in-store sales mechanics, that is unit 2, and from unit 2 we'll discuss factors to be considered when selecting sales promotional tools. I'm your trainer Priyanka Majumdar from Retail Services Not a Skill Center. Let's start our today's class with our lesson objective. The lesson objective is to at the end of the class, you should be able to explain the factors that to be considered while selecting a sales promotional tool for your retail store. In our previous classes of retail promotion, we already discussed about the different ways of sales promotional or different ways of tools in sales promotion that are customer-oriented tools are samples, coupons, premiums, refunds, bonus packs, etc. And trade-oriented tools are contest, trade allowances, point of purchase displays, training programs, trade show, etc. So why we need the sales promotional tools? Retailers will use many methods to try and attract customers. And this is done to encourage customers to buy the product. And it is also helping building an everlasting relationship with your customer and to retain your customer. So that's why we need this kind of tools. So we will talk now about the factors while selecting a sales promotional tool. There are 6 factors while designing or developing a sales promotional tool. First is objective. Second is budget. Third is audience. Fourth is reach. Fifth is stages in product life cycle. And last is competitive activity. So we can find a mnemonic from this 6 factors, that is COBRAs, where C stands for competitive activity, O stands for objective, B stands for budget, R stands for reach, A stands for audience, S stands for stages in product life cycle. So this mnemonic will help us in remembering all the 6 factors while selecting a sales promotional tools. The first factor for developing in-store sales mechanic is to find out the objective. When we are going to develop an in-store sales mechanics or in-store sales promotional tool, we'll have to find out whether we are targeting the short term for customer buying behavior or for enhancing the customer relationship for long-term issues. So whether it is a sample, coupons, loyalty programs, trade, seminars, everything will depend on our objective. The budget. After the objective is determined, now we have to find out and plan the sales promotion budget to forecast and determine the future course of action. So we have to segregate our needs in different variants like advertisement, in-store sales displays, SMS. After determining the budget, the retailer have to search for its audience. Every population is not your audience. So the retailer have to use the market research and market segmentation to target an audience. We have discussed elaborately what is market research in our entrepreneurship class. So market research is basically of 2 types, primary and secondary. So in finding out your audience, you have to go through both the primary and secondary market research and also have to do a market segmentation. This will tell us the retailer where the audience is located. It will give an indication about the needs, attitude, preference, and the benefits the customer is expecting from your product. Now we'll talk about the reach. This is the measure of the percentage of people in the target market who are exposed to the advertising campaign during a given period. So you have to find out whom you are targeting and what type of advertisement campaign you are going through. Like if you are giving advertisement of Audi car in a very rural and remote place, so it will not get a good reach because it is a luxury car and the people from the remote places will not be able to buy your product. So you have to find out where and how to approach the customer. Example, 3 months of advertising campaign to reach 70% of target. So this can be your reach percentage according to your advertisement campaign. The fifth factor that we have to consider while determining a promotional technique or promotional mechanic in our store, that is stages in product life cycle. Every product has a life cycle. It has 4 distinct phases. First is introduction, second is growth, third is maturity, and last is decline or saturation. So a retailer or the marketer has to take care of all the stages while determining their advertisement campaign or their promotional tools. So each of the stages of product life cycle have different characteristics. In the first stage, that is introduction stage, characterized by lower sales volume, little competition, lower demand, high cost of production, customer have to be prompted to try your product, and the retailer cannot make so much of money at this stage. Our second stage is growth stage. In this stage, the cost reduced due to economics of scale. The sales volume increasingly significant. Profitability begin to rise. Public become aware of your product because of your advertisement. Competition begin to rise. An increased competition tends to make your price lower. To fight the competitor, you have to develop new strategies. You have to develop new promotional tools, and you have to go for decrease in pricing of your product. The third stage is maturity stage. It is characterized by lower cost of production because of increase in production volume and experience curve effect. Second is sales volume is in peak and market saturation is reached. Third is increase in competition because of new player entering in the market. The retailer or the marketer has to drop down their prices because of proliferation of competing products. Brand differentiation has to be made and the features of diversification has to be emphasized to get an increased market share. Sixth is industrial profits go down. So the retailer or the marketer in this stage has to focus on their advertisement or promotional campaign, because in our previous class of pull and push marketing we have already discussed that there are some strategies in pull marketing by which we can create a brand value in the market. Our fourth stage is saturation or decline stage. Here the cost become counter optimal, sales volume decline, prices and profitability diminish. So here we can see in all the stages, in stage 1 that is introduction stage, in stage 2 that is growth stage, and in stage 3 that is maturity stage, the advertisement campaign or the promotional tools cost is in peak. So we have to develop our promotional mechanics or the promotional tools in this 3 stages of product life cycle so we can give or get an optimal result. So in this class we have discussed about only 5 factors which is very essential in developing in-store sales mechanics. In our next class we'll discuss about the last factor, that is the 6th factor, that is competitive activity. If you have any query regarding these 5 factors, kindly reach me in my contact number, that is 8474-077-687. Thank you. Stay home, save lives.